In the previous lecture, we have created one more commit in our Git repository. And we have used two most common Git operations: adding files to staging area and committing files to Git repository. And using this diagram, let me explain you one more command, git checkout. We will talk about this command in the next section in details, but for now let me just give you a short overview of it. Okay, here are three git areas: working directory, staging area or index, and git repository. Using git add command, we can move files from working directory into staging area. And as you already know, we can add to staging area either untracked files or modified files. And we can add either specific file or all files that were modified or that were just added to our working directory. That is git add command. After that, when files are already located in staging area or index, we can commit changes using git commit command. Every commit includes such information as author name and author email, date of the commit and commit message or commit description. And after committing changes, files or file that were located in staging area are moved to Git repository. And the status of those files is changed to untracked. That's how you can move files from working directory to Git repository. And it is necessary to move them through the staging area. It is also an option to move files from working directory to Git repository with single git commit command. We will use it later on. But under the hood, files will be moved through the staging area as well. Okay, when files were committed and you have more than one commit in your project, you can jump between different versions of your project. At the moment in our project there are two commits, this one root commit and the second commit that points to parent commit. And now we already have two versions of our project. This version where this commit stands at the root of the tree, and second version where second commits point to this second tree. And we can easily change versions of our project by jumping between those two commits. And that's where git checkout command is used. You can use this command in order to retrieve specific version of your project from git repository. And with this command, git retrieves files and folders from git repository and puts them into working directory. And under the hood, this command also replaces files in staging area. And after checking out specific version of your project, you can easily move on and make, for example, any changes, add new files to your project, commit those changes, and so on. That's what we will do in the next section. But before moving to the next section, let me also show you this diagram and explain you how different file states relate to different git areas. Again, there are three areas: working directory, staging area index, and git repository. And when you add new file to working directory, it becomes untracked. It means that untracked files are located only in working directory and are absent in staging area or git repository. After that, when you, for example, stage untracked file, its state becomes staged. And this file is now located also in staging area. Of course, this file is still located in working directory as well, but for simplicity, I have added stage state only under staging area. When you commit changes of the file, its state changes to unmodified state. And after committing, git writes file into git repository, it remains in staging area, and of course, it remains in working directory. And when there are no changes in your project and all previous files and folders were committed, all files will have unmodified state and will be located in all three areas. When you take any of unmodified files that is already in working directory, in staging area and in git repository and modify it, it becomes modified and it remains modified in working directory. If you want to move it to staging area, you should use git add command and stage it. And after this operation, file becomes staged. and now it is located in staging area as well. I mean changed version of the file. But until you will commit changes, Git repository will still contain only old version of specific file. And when you commit changes, this modified file transitions from stage state to unmodified, and again all three areas, working directory, staging area and Git repository, will become fully consistent. Okay, that's how file states are distributed among different Git areas. I hope now it is fully clear what is file state, how file states are changed, and what happens under the hood when you use git add and git commit commands. Okay, that's all for this section, and at the moment picture of our project looks like this. There are two commits, root commit and parent commit, and there are actually two trees that point to different blobs. This tree points to two blobs, and this tree points to three blobs. In the next section, we will start using git checkout command. I'll explain you what is head and what is branch. I'll see you in the next section. Bye-bye.